The Sisters of St Joseph and the Sisters of St Joseph of Lochinvar are two congregations of religious women founded in Australia by Mary MacKillop and Fr Julian Tenison Woods, with the express purpose of responding to the cry of those made poor or those pushed to the edges of society. For over 150 years, the Sisters and their partners in mission have established schools and provided support for women and children in need, or those made homeless by poverty or domestic violence, through their health and welfare works. The Sisters have lived among and walked beside First Nations people, migrants, asylum seekers, refugees, and those made poor in Peru, Brazil, Timor-Leste, New Guinea and Fiji, relieving suffering and bringing hope.
I can say that the Sisters of St. Joseph are a group of remarkable women who have, in many cases, and still are, doing whatever they can do to make the world a better place.
Our hope lies in our willingness and our determination to collaborate, because we recognise the interconnectedness of the whole of life. We recognise that across the globe and across the cosmos, that everything is connected to everything else.
We're very realistic about our capacities and extremely generous with our resources. So we have sisters working in all different sorts of ministries and places, some more surprising than others, like involved with the seafarers, involved with slavery, refugees, asylum seekers, neighbourhood ministries, education, in fact, anything that makes a difference.
Some help people learn English as a new language, migrants, refugees, others are doing involved in spiritual direction. I myself, I do a lot of photography, and then I sell these cards and raise funds for counter-trafficking the women project.
Well, I suppose in the last 20 years, there's been a really growing awareness that we're caught in the great turning across the planet. We're really aware that this has been human-induced and it's through natural circumstances. And even though politically it has been a real issue, particularly in Australia with the previous government, around the disagreements of the value of climate change and whether or not we were responsible, I think it's widely accepted now that we have come to a tipping point that's been seen in global warming, that's seen in floods and droughts and bushfires, all the extinction that's taking place. And when we look across the globe, the huge shifts of migration as a group and as individuals to move towards a new consciousness in our reflection, in our planning, and I suppose in our recognition of Laudato Si, of the Pope's call to a consciousness of Earth and what we are doing across our planet. And I suppose this is our attempt to do something about it.